Everyone, so quick video to show you guys my latest journal, Alice in Wonderland journal, that will be all available in my Etsy store, and I've got a few other bits to show you as well. Finally getting through doing the decorating and stuff, guys, so I'm definitely going to be coming on starting from tomorrow and doing some tutorials and things again. It's just been crazy. I'm slowly but surely catching up after COVID. I'm not going to go into a lot of personal stuff, but things have been absolutely nuts, so I'm slowly getting there, and I'm going to get my channel back up and on the go again. But thank you to everybody that has joined me, thank you to everybody that has stayed with me, and we will definitely get this channel back up and running. So hopefully 2021 will be a lot better as well, considering videos and things like that. It's just been crazy nuts. Anyway, this is my journal that I've been working on. I've been working on this for about a week, and the reason being is just because I've been so busy, guys. Like I said, I haven't had a chance to really do it. What I'm going to show you first of all, in my Etsy store, I'm now doing Elvis cups. So I am doing other personalised cups, and there is options on my Etsy that you can just go on and you can pick your options. I have got 21, I bought the SVG files, so I've got 21 different styles of cups that I can make. These are just some of them, so these are listed on there. If there is anything else that you would like, just let me know and you can email me. So I've got those, so they are a fab. You can get your name and things, I can personalise them or personalise them with your messages. So I've got that, and then I have got these, I've got 4 of these left. I did have 15, but when I got them in, my mum had orders at her work, so we got these done, and it wasn't exactly this. These ones say eat, sleep, craft, repeat, and all that was changed was some of these words in here for the people at my mum work, at my mum's work. But on the Etsy, I have got 4 of these ones left, the 8 eat, sleep, craft, repeat, and it says wee bottles. Are handy, so when I go back into the office, this is what I'm going to be taking on all of these. So I've got them on the site as well. Now, next thing I'm going to show you is I've got some die cuts. Now, there's different variations, and I've managed to do it, work it out, because I wasn't sure how to do it on Etsy. You can just go on, see your die cuts, it will give you, pick which one you want, and pick it in black or white, and then that's you sorted. So the first ones, let me just quickly run through these. These all come in a pack of 10. You've got these. I am going to be adding to these on a regular basis. These are just the ones that I have got up just now. Like I said, I've just been so busy, I've not had a chance to do a lot. But we have got, so you'll get a pack of 10 of these ones. Okay. These ones are the peach and red florals in the options. Then I've got these ones. Again, these are all packs of 10, guys. I have got the bats in the circle for Halloween. Love them, I think they're really cool. You got those. Now, when you get them sent out to you, you'll get them in your wee paper bags. They will be folded over, and they will have, I've got these Alice in Wonderland thank you stickers, which are just absolutely gorgeous. Those will seal the bag, and you'll also get one of my Scottish Crafter, the Alice stickers that I made, and that will be on the back of the bag. Now, I was waiting on, let me just show you, these coming in. Okay, these didn't actually come in till Thursday, so these are the Please Do Not Bend envelopes. I have got these in now for the ephemera. These are just some of them, I've got more of them, but Please Do Not Bend means that you're going to get, I'm going to put the bag inside there, and it means when you get them delivered. So if you have ordered the die cuts from me, they are on their way, guys. I was just waiting on these, I didn't want to send them out in case they got damaged, but please be assured they are sent out now and they are in these. Okay, so that is those ones. I also have the witch. So you get 10 of your witch. A good size. And you all know that I love Halloween crafting, so it's right up my street. What is in here? We have, well, this one is the red rose. I've just put that under red rose. Again, you'll get the pack of 10. I think they're absolutely beautiful. So you will get those. I will link my Etsy down in the description box, guys, if you want to go over and have a look. Thank you to everybody that has purchased. I have been so, so busy. I got an order in for 50 mugs. 50, yep. So I'm almost through them. So that's what I've been working on as well. So the ghost is the next one. So your Halloween ghost. Again, you can see that is a good size. So all these wee toppers are cool for your scrapbooking, your journals, your card making. This one is one of my favourites. You get the coffin. Look at this. You get the coffin. So they come in two pieces. So obviously you'll get 10 of this and 10 of the vampire. Okay. And let me just find him. So although on the website, like on the Etsy, it'll say a 10 piece. This is classed as one piece. You'll get 10 of each. And then you get the wee vampire. Look at that. Isn't that really cool? So that is that one. And that is just the coffin and vampire. And then I have got these ones. I thought these were really handy. I've got tons of these in here. The Happy Halloween sentiment toppers. Because if you're getting die cuts, you know, you're going to need the sentiments to go with it. So we have got Happy Halloween. Okay. This one is the, oh, I love this. This is the pastel floral. Beautiful. Pack of 10 of those. And that one is not, that one's a personal order. Right, okay. So, all of those in Etsy, and then this is going to be listed in my Etsy as well. So, this is a Dark Alice journal. It has 104 pages. It is 8.25 by 5.5. It is hardback, fabric covered. I've put on, I just love that. Look at that. I've put on all the trim and the purple and the blue on the side. It makes it look like it's got this gorgeous like trim. Love it. And then in here somewhere we have got, oops, I've put on the beads with the rabbit. And then there's another one somewhere, if I can find it. Let me fish it somewhere. There it is. We have got more beads. I don't know if you can see that, guys. And then you've got the stacking suit of cards. Okay. So, like I said, it is hardback. There is my stamp, my S on the back. And this is actually, this was an actual vintage book cover. All I done was I reinforced it on the inside with my sticky back paper and the velvet. So it is double reinforced, so the actual spine itself will last forever. You have got the metal book corners. I put on the gorgeous matching foam flowers. And this image on the front, I love it. Look at Alice and the rabbit. It's so whimsical. And then you've got the ribbon tie. I have burned them all the edges so they're not going to fray, and you've got the beautiful blue metal bits. I always forget what these are called. It drives me absolutely insane, and you know, I think my brain does it on purpose. What do you call them? Ah, they're not grommets, they're eyelets. Eyelets, that's it. Right, okay, so you've got the ribbon tie in the matching sort of tealy colour. So let's open it up and have a look. Let me make sure that I am in frame, which I am. So I have got the matching fabric pocket on the inside. Just put a wee Alice on there. I will link the kits that I have used down in the description box as well from the Etsy sellers that I bought them from. If you want to go over and purchase the kits, obviously that's where I got them to make these journals, okay? In the pocket, I have made myself a, or made... a bookmark. This is from the Stamperia Alice pad, so I made that. This is black velvet. So the inside of the book is black velvet. Okay, we have this wee sort of file folder that I made on my Cricut, and all I've done in here, obviously this is nice for keeping receipts and pictures and stuff, but in each of the wee file folders I've put in one of papers from the Alice kit. So it looks really old because I've cut it all the way around, so that is really cool, and that just slips in there, and I just think that's a nice addition to your journal to keep stuff in. That stays in there. We have got this wee envelope, part of the kit as well, and you open it up and you've got the Wonderland mail. Sorry about my nails, guys, I'm not getting done again till the 27th, and I had to take my other ones off because they were so grown out. I had them on for, they were acrylics, I had them on for 4 weeks, and you can see the line there where they were grown out to, so I had to take them off, but I'm getting them done again on the 27th, so thank goodness for that. So you've got that wee envelope, and then you have got this tag, the carte postale tag, and just with the fibres that you can journal on. So my Wonderland journal, oh sorry, just let me get up on my seat. open it up. So you've got some die cuts throughout. You've got the beautiful imagery from the kits. Two different kits in this book that I used. Then you've got that that says notes. Here I've made a wee pocket. I've put some pom-pom trim in on the purple. And you've got the beautiful Alice ribbon. This ribbon I actually sell in my Etsy store as well. So in here, in this pocket, you see this says Bank of Wonderland. I've put in some of these beautiful photo mats with the purple, shiny. I think they're gorgeous. And just some of these stickers. I made a tag with the tumbling hearts. And then you've got this wee thing that I cut out from my Cricut as well. It's just like a wee photo book. It just keeps going on. So I just thought that was sweet for popping in some wee photos. Or just for putting in wee notes. But I just thought it was a nice wee extra. So I've popped that in there. Got the Dark Alice with the Cheshire Cat. There is some of the pastel florals that I sell. Some more die cuts. Some music paper. Some of the beautiful imagery from the kit. And then here again, look at this. I love, 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 love this. And you can put a title here and then put your photograph on there. I just think it's lovely. Then you have got the White Rabbit. And in this bag, I've put in another wee photo mat, this time with the purple, hearts. And then you've got the two wee journaling cards with Mad Hatter and off with her head. And then I love that in the blues, it's beautiful. It says, "You used to be much more muchier, you've lost your muchness." Here I've got one of my paper clips that I've made just with my fibres on it, and then I've made this beautiful wee envelope. This is a Cheshire Cat, but it's actually from Julia McNeil's stamps from her our Curious Wonders collection. And yeah, I just love it. I just made that wee envelope of just having fun. And then you've got your either journaling card or your large photo mat on the inside. That's just one of those CD ones that I made. I just think that was a wee cute addition. Doily. More of that beautiful paper. And then you've got the Queen. One of these gorgeous stickers. An entry ticket. This vellum. This is Kanban vellum. That's one of my favourite pages. A Mad Tea Party. Isn't that cute? And then you've got another pocket. And in here, I have just put in another photo mat. That gorgeous paper. We're all mad here. And it's got the pom-pom trim. And then this wee one, it's just the same. It's got the love heart, it's got the Mad Tatter, and it's got another sheet of the paper. Like, in here for you to keep stuff in. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? I didn't even know if I'd want to do anything to that page. Maybe do some doodling. Cheshire Cat. And then we have this bag. And in this one, I have got another wee journaling card or photo mat. Oops. Pop that in here. And then we've got, we're all mad here, and the matching wee Alice card as well. Okay. Just some flowers that I've cut out from some paper that I had. We're all mad here. Look at that face. The twins and then the twins paper. This is one of the sheets of papers, and I like putting these in. You guys that watch me regularly will know that I like putting, because I like this. In fact, you could put like photographs here and then journal on this side. Another pocket. This journal card here. Here you have got this one. That's one of the Stamperia ones that I've just made into a card. And then this matching tag. So lots of space to keep all your bits and pieces in. Love that. Just a wee vellum flower that matched the rabbit. And then the centre of the signature. And what I like about it, it lies flat. Again, the more you use it, the more it will lie flat. But you can absolutely, at the end of the day, like I always say, these journals are for journaling. So you want to have lots of space to be able to write and to stick things in and keep all your memories in. So absolutely, it's important that you can lie them flat and write in them. Look at that, isn't that beautiful? And then I fussy cut Alice out and put her there. This bag has just the same. It's got another one of the wee cards and then two of the journaling cards. I like the dark Alice. It's just something a bit different as well. Look at that. Die cuts. And again, I sell these die cuts in my shop, guys. You get a set of 8. I've got 2 different sets. You've got set A and set B. I've actually got more dies coming, so I'm going to have a set C soon as well. So you've got here. That's nice, eh? The Wonderland Journal for writing on. More of my ephemera. We're all mad here. And then this is a larger file folder. I didn't glue this one this time. I've just left it for adding stuff in. And then I've put in another one of the sheets of paper that looks really vintagey. So that just goes in that one. We've got Alice on the front. And then this goes on. Yeah. Obviously you can move it about the book, whatever you like. But that's just where I've popped it. In this bag. Again, we have the larger journaling card this time, or photo mat, and those 2 cards. So still loads of scope to decorate your book. Then we have the Humpty Dumpty from the Dark Alice kit. She meets him along her way, off with her head. Then I've got another CD envelope that I've made. This is from stamps from Julia McNeil as well. It's just got the curious, curious, curious all the way around it. This is a wee tuck spot. I have got another one of the file folders that I made from my Cricut. I've got a Stamperia card that I made, journaling card. And I've got a wee tag with the tumbling hearts that I made as well. And there's the other side of that notes page. And then you have got the black velvet on the back and a beautiful space for a photo. So that is my latest Alice Journal. Any questions at all, guys, you can either email me, you can contact me through my Etsy site, or you can speak to me in the comments down below. Please hit me a big thumbs up and I will see you again during the week or tomorrow. I'm planning on tomorrow, fingers crossed, with some tutorials. So thank you. See you soon. Bye bye.